Now, I really love doing extensions, and it came from an issue in my back that came about because I was doing too many abdominal curls, which I don't do anymore. And I have to say, just recently being part of a study, I know my core's working really well. So I've ticked that box, I'm happy. So this is a variation of a lower back exercise. Now, with all my exercises, we build. So we start with something easy, then we build on and build on. So if your clients have got any major issues with the lower back, like a prolapsed disc or whatever, they might not go down through the full journey with the abduction. But we start off on the floor with a very safe back exercise, and that is face down, arms outstretched, and you work opposite arm and leg. So let's start off with the right arm and my left leg. So breathe out, come back down. Exhale, come back down. Now you'll notice I'm not alternating. I'm going to stick to one side and then I'll repeat the whole thing on the opposite side. So breathe out and come back down. It's quite slow too. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I use music at about 128 BPMs. So it's quite slow and it's really controlled. So then the next one, I lift up. And after I've done two blocks of this, so probably about 16 repetitions in total. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I add the arm change. So I lift up, take the arm to the side, back to the center, drop down. Lift up, take the arm to the side, back to the center, and drop down. And all that does is it means I sustain the contraction at the top a little bit longer. So the breathing technique is super important here, and you want to encourage two things. One, exhale as you come out, come up, and inhale. And as they come up, lift the pelvic floor, take it out to the side, come back in, and then relax the pelvic floor. So it's not hold, 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 hold and relax, hold and relax. Now remember that for a lot of your clients that they might be able to do 8 repetitions with the pelvic floor successfully, then they'll start fatiguing and using other muscles. So don't cue it for every single repetition, right? Maybe cue it for this round and then not cue it at all, okay? So lift up, exhale, come back in and down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I'll do 8 of those, 2 blocks, whatever. Then I'll add the leg action. So lift up, take the leg to the side, back to the center, and down. Now, if you've got people with a prolapsed disc or even back issues, this could be problematic. So encourage people to work at their own level. If you're a good exercise instructor, if you're a personal trainer, well, you need to follow through with what you know you're qualified to do. But it adds a little bit of quadratus lumborus, lumborum work, as a lateral flexor work without actually having to flex the spine. Yeah? So lift, out, in, down. Lift, out, in, down. Again, 8 repetitions of this movement pattern. And the arm just comes down to shoulder height, and the leg just moves out to the side as far as it feels comfortable. So after, again, doing 8 repetitions of this, I'll lift up both arms, both legs, in, down. Lift, out, in, down. So again, only 8 repetitions of this. And then I usually get my clients to push back, have a rest, and then do the same thing on the opposite side. One point is to try and keep their faces looking down during this exercise because it helps with the neck staying in a neutral position and they won't get any neck pain. The other thing too is to encourage them to lift off the floor as high as they feel comfortable. So it's a great back exercise, a little bit of variety from the normal back extension work. Highly recommend it. I remember when I was early in my career, they often recommend that you do as much back as you did abdominals, and I just really pay any attention to that. But I pay for it. Pay for it in the long run. So do your back extension work. It's super important, especially young people sitting down a lot. And that's this week's muscle conditioning and pelvic floor safety.